This is James Howard, and this is, I'm showing off with my Magellan Ice Chest cooler. Now, this cooler is really nice. We live in Texas, and they have a cutting board. You can kind of section it off any way you want to do it. You got three little sections here, so you can put it any way you want to section it off. You got a little tray to put anywhere too, so you can put your produce up there so they don't get wet and stuff like that. This is a really, really good cooler. It's vacuum sealed at the top, so it holds the ice and stuff really well. Now, we stay in Texas, so it's about, right now we're in August, so it's about 110 out here every single day. So it'll probably last 3 days in 110 weather, but we had it out here in June, and it'll last about 4 days in June. In June we have about 89, 99 type of weather. So it's pretty good for that type of weather environment. If you in 110 weathers, Texas, Arizona, maybe Florida, it's gonna hold it, but if you open it up too much, then it'll probably run out about 3-4 days gonna be your tops. But if you in June when the weather's like 80 and stuff like that, you should be really good. Good thing about it though, like I said, it is vacuum sealed, so when you put it down, it clicks one time, and you press it down, it clicks again. So let me see, can I do it again without talking? That's the first click, and that was the second click. And the good thing about it is, when you turn it over here, you can open it up from both sides. It's the same concept. Double click, and where is it at? You have a beer opener over here, which is really, really good. Don't mind my wife garden stuff. She's a gardener. This is a 75 quart, right?
Mm-hmm.
75 quart. So you can hold a lot of stuff in here. We'll put the link in the description. There is two coolers like this. One is the smaller version. This is the big one. Because we do live in Texas and we do a lot of camping. You have tires on one side. You don't have tires on the other side. You can actually pick it up. And it's real good plastic too. So it got a little weight to it. So when you pack it down with ice and stuff like that, be really comfortable. It is really, really heavy.
But does get hot in the sun.
Yeah, it gets really, really hot in the sun. I would say it is not better than a Yeti for sure. Yeti is probably one of the best coolers, but it is probably the second to me of cooler wise. But the plastic is really heavy duty. It do have that vacuum seal technology. So like I said, you can open it up. It got it right here. You see the black right here. And like I said, it is moist because we do use it a lot. And like, you got the black right here to seal it. So when you put it down like here, it click one time right there. And click two times to make sure it's vacuum is sealed perfectly. And this is overall a good cooler to us. We have tried it in the weather when it was like 80, 90, and it worked really, really well. But when it gets to the weather where, like I said, we stay in Texas, so when the weather gets to about, like I said, about 100, right now it's like 100 and 110, so the index be like 115. It does well. It's gonna hold it probably about 3 days, maybe 4 days if you're not opening up frequently. Like if you open up too much and keep on opening and closing, and you might get 3 days out of it. If you keep it closing, you might get a good 4 days out of it when the weather is 100, 110. But if the weather's like 80, 90, 95, 96, maybe 70, oh, you're gonna have this cooler gonna be good to go for a while. And like I said, overall, it's a good cooler. We love it. We had it for about, 2 months now?
Yeah.
We had it about 2 months, and we love it. And like the channel, subscribe, and we're gonna keep on bringing you more camping stuff, and we out of here.